So I was thinking of doing the Melroon Dagon, is that his name? Am I seeing that? Maybe I'm seeing it right. Wrong. Delroon Magon, Mehroon Dagon, anyway. That Razor quest.
And here comes my first visitor. The Museum of the Mythic Dawn is open, friend.
He's been standing here for quite a while.
Yes. My collection of artifacts from a group that toppled an empire. Why don't you come in? You can browse the displays and we can talk. I have a job, you look perfect. And here comes my first visitor.
Oh, really?
The Museum of the Mythic Dawn is open. Never mind that.
I forgot he force greets.
But I have my own reasons for opening this museum, and I'm not changing my mind. I have a collection of artifacts from the group that toppled an empire. Their importance to history cannot be forgotten. Why don't you come in? You can browse the displays and we can talk. I have a job you look perfect for. Let's talk inside.
Sounds great. So I'm gonna just race through his little tour he does. I forgot he does a tour, so. I was role-playing as the impatient adventurer who just wants to get to the point.
But the tapestries hung here. That burned paper is all that remains of the fabled Mysterium Xarxes, the blasphemous book written by Mehroons. Those robes were worn during the Mythic Dawn secret meetings. Ah, yes.
You can just totally interrupt him and have him talk about something else.
On the Mysterium Xarxes were written by the Mythic Dawn cult leader, Mankar Camoran.
But,
He promised a paradise awaited his followers when they died.
My ENB is messing with the banners hanging in here. You can't see the banners. The number of lit objects in this room has surpassed its limits. So they're all dark.
Did you have any questions about the museum? Or would you rather talk business? A little history first. After the Oblivion Crisis, a number of groups cropped up dedicated to wiping out the remnants of the Mythic Dawn. One of these groups found Mehroon's Razor, the artifact of Dagon. They split it into three fragments and pledged to keep them apart forever. That was almost 150 years ago, and the pieces are still being kept by the descendants of that group, and they're right here, in Skyrim. At least two of the owners, Gunzel and Draskua, are dangerous marauders. And the third owner, Jorgen, I only know he lives in Morthal. Here are my notes about them. I'll gladly pay you for getting the pieces any way you can. No questions asked. Good luck finding the fragments.
Oh, even the floor tiles are messed up with this number of lights in here. Oh well. I'm not getting a whole lot of vampires in my towns and villages, which is weird. So I'm guessing it's because I have Serana with me, and maybe once I send her home, then those kinds of disturbances in the forest will start showing up.
Looking to hire a boat?
But that will have to wait.
Where are you headed?
Oh.
Mm-hmm. Till next time.
Who shot an arrow at me? What's going on here? Someone missed something and the arrow flew all the way over here and hit me in the foot. I don't hear any screaming and yelling going on though. A fight! Yeah, let's go up there anyway. Take a look. Oh, the chickens are here. Something was after the chickens. The chickens?
What
okay.
Smell?
I heard there were wolves.
I find this a bit scary.
So just wolves then? Okay, let's go back to the boat. Need to head to Solitude. There's something I have to do with Solitude, I think. You guys coming? We're missing somebody. Oh, here she comes. I need to find a...
Looking to hire a... Where are you headed?
A guy companion.
Climb on in the boat and get comfortable.
I don't know why I've got these females with me. Well, I guess Lydia's my house, Carl, so that's why she always comes. You know, if your first house, Carl, in the game was a dude, I'm guessing the dude house, Carl, would be the most popular companion in the game instead of... Lydia! I've assigned you Lydia as your new house, Carl. You know, it would be... It'd be some dude's name. Instead of Lydia. I bet you that would have happened. That would have changed the whole thing. Because the first thing you do when you see Lydia is, oh, can I marry her? Is there marriage in this game of Skyrim? I don't know. I don't know if there was marriage in the vanilla game or not, or if that was a...
You talk to Egg Brothers. Deja has no words for you.
Or was there like a, you know, buy your own house plugin that you had to download? Then you could marry Lydia. Oh, but you have kids though, right? I suppose we could find room for them. You know, that kind of thing. Why is my game acting up? Oh, Windows 10, what are you doing to me? I'm trying to make a video here. I thought I heard some piggies running around. When I see piggies running out into the street, I'm thinking, oh, something's getting hurt. Something's getting hoit, but...
My father was all the family I ever had. I felt so lost when he died.
Oh, let's change your outfit.
The crew of the Red Wave's my family now.
Why are you wearing this robe? Oh, there was... Okay, there's a wolf thing out here. Okay. Kill it. A fight.
I'd better get going.
That's way better. She looks way better now.
You will make a lovely pair.
This torch doesn't really light up all that much, does it? Just like a real torch. I've tried several torch mods in the past. This is the best. It's got a decent color coming from the torch and a decent area of light around it. Most torches, you know what they're like. They never burn out. They light up the whole frickin' game.
Where's these vampires coming from? We need to wipe them out before things get worse.
Yes. You guys keep telling me about these vampires, and I look, and I look, and I don't find any. Is he telling me from like two times ago when there was a vampire here? Is there one now? I don't hear any screaming. I don't hear.
Torig's death has turned the whole town on its head.
I don't hear any crying. I hate when there's a vampire here and I have to kill it because my companions start fights with, they do that. They blow something up and then the guards come after us for killing innocent people. Well, there's one. Where's the rest? Where are you? Oh, see? My torch burned out. Right when it's supposed to. When I need it the least. Okay. Let's try the candle thing this time. I have a patch for that too. So the candle light is in front of you instead of behind you. Best invention ever. So it actually works. It lights up things in the game. But not too far away. I mean, it doesn't frickin' light up the whole town. Make it daylight or nothing. It seems to work pretty well with this EMB I'm using. Oh! Okay. Something was going on here. What's wrong with his arms? He looked like his arms were tied behind his back or something. Oh, people were shooting at her with arrows.
Yes?
Oh, thank you. Divines bless your kind heart.
Until next time.
Well, that's weird. A generic beggar with that voice? It's pretty rare. Usually, okay, so what was that? There was no vampire yet, right? Just the thralls? So where's the actual vampire? Did he or she fall through the floor? Where are they? This guy's standing out here. That usually means the fight was where he was. The fight had to have been right by the marketplace, because the laborers all ran away from here. Went their own ways. Usually there's a laborer standing in the graveyard. I don't see anyone in the graveyard. This guy doesn't care, he just circles around. There should be a mod that makes him do other things besides just mumble to himself and walk in circles. Well, I'm getting used to how dark my game is now with this ENB. Before I was like, oh no, it's one of those dark lighting games where you can't see crap at night. That was my first thought when I installed NLA 2.0. Now it's like I don't even notice. I don't even notice anymore when it's pitch black outside. It's like no big deal. It's no big deal. It's called nighttime. That's what nighttime is. You get spoiled by the vanilla lighting. Because my last ENB just used vanilla lighting. So even though there was no full moon outside, or full moons outside, the ground was always lit up as if there were full moons outside. Always. You look up, it's pitch black in the sky. Oh, come on. You guys. Let's get some guards to join us. We need to go find the general. Where is he?
Stop that.
Where are you? Is he in bed? Oh, come on. Where? Probably would help if I turned on the quest markers. Oh, oh. Did I see an arrow? Oh, there's an arrow. How come I didn't notice that arrow before? He's just sitting there by himself. Oh, where's my torch?
We will oust Ulfric from Windhelm soon enough, and when we do, I'll have his head on a plate. Excellent work, soldier. I have to admit, I had my doubts it even existed. Did you run into any trouble?
That's as my what shoulder I like to pops. Hear.
I'll get the full report from Legate Ricca. Now then, I need someone I can trust to deliver a message of.
Was he just sitting here in the dark?
Of Whiterun. We have it on good authority that Ulfric has raised enough men to attack the city of Whiterun. The Jarl, however, refuses the Legion's support. This missive should convince him. Be aware, soldier. These documents contain sensitive intelligence for the Jarl's eyes only.
Staying safe, I hope. I'll take my leave then.
They're no longer suspicious of me, so they go back to their posts. Still looking for vampires. Or a vampire, a certain one. The ringleader. These things come in threes. Usually one vampire and two thralls, or one vampire and two death hounds. I don't have those quests starting up yet where it's got that traveler dude walking around. He comes walking up to you. And all he says is, "Die! Why won't you die?" You know, that kind of a thing.
He keeps making eyes at me.
You should tell him to mind his own business.
Aya, you're so mean. I don't think he means anything by it.
Anyway, he hasn't been showing up in my game yet. I probably have to talk to Ysran a little bit more instead of just that one time.
Be sure to watch your finger positions. Especially during the transitions.
Plus, I'm using U-Sleep, so I don't know what U-Sleep's done to the game. Oh, I'm being followed by guards. What did I do now? Oh, I must be waving my weapon arms in the air again. All right, then. I was looking for Vilya's friend, the
my
bard.
Position, Dean of History, actually covers a wide range of subjects. I teach poetry, writing, history, and the finer points of court life.
I wanted to see if his...
Come to the right place.
What's his name? Wilfred or something? I wanted to see if he had made it back to the Bard's College.
I suppose I should return to my papers.
Or if he's still hanging out in Dawnstar and I have to move him over here. Or do I have to finish the Bard's quest and then he'll move over here on his own? Yeah, his whole quest, the Bard's quest, was sort of unfinished for Vilya. I mean, it works. It does the trick. But there's some loose ends it needs to tie up still. I don't know if Vilya's been updated in the last 4 years, though. Oh, there's a guard. Or something. Who was that? I couldn't read.
I'm going to find whoever did this.
If I stand there long enough, they'll say, "Are you responsible for this? Or do you know something about this?" And if you say no or yes, you can actually go to jail just by standing next to a dead person. Kind of neat. Let's get some guards to follow me, because okay, they're watching me. Oh, where's... what's his name? Corpulus? Corpulus? Oh, get out of the way.
Smell that fresh air?
Yeah, yeah.
Truly, this is a good place to play a song.
Yes, so do it.
Hello there, friend. For a generous fellow traveler. But of course, Ysmir's blessing on you. Our hero claims a warrior's heart.
Oh, maybe that Corpulus guy's asleep. I didn't know this at the time.
With a voice wielding power of the ancient art, believe the dragonborn comes.
But I forgot they had extra beds in this tavern. I want the guards to follow me. For some reason I thought he slept up here, but
and the legend yet grows.
This is for guests.
By blade or by spell. If you want it dead, I'll make it dead. All you need to do is pay my fee. The blade can be as lethal as the spell.
I think Corpulus's kid used to sleep up there. So now it's Belran's bed. All right then. Okay, this is the room of beds in here. Immersive Citizens AI Overhaul technically is called Beds of Skyrim.
Welcome to the Winking Skeever. Here, take a look at this. Some of the Jarl's men came by and left this bounty letter.
Isn't that cool? He gave me a bounty. First time in like 5 years.
Remember the Winking Skeever next time you're footsore.
I never get bounties in Skyrim. Let's see if I can get these guards away. Oh, they're going home.
I'll take my leave then.
They're tired of following me around. Who is this dragonborn loser guy sneaking around in the tavern? He's wasting our time. I don't know why. I just now thought of. I'm not sure what reminded me of this, but I was just now thinking of the time I did a George Harrison impersonation in front of George Harrison. That was back. When was that? That was back in 1995? Five-ish? 1994-ish?
All right, then.
I was at a coworker's house to fix a computer. And it was in his living room. You know, I knock on the door, he lets me in. I says, "So where's the computer at?" And he says, "Oh, it's in the living room, under the desk." So I go into the living room. And there's a, you know, a computer desk in there against the wall. Near the TV. And, you know, I'm on my hands and knees reaching around behind the computer. The computer's under the desk, so I'm reaching behind the computer to the Septimo tube? Unplug the cables from behind it and pull the computer out. Get ready to open it. I think it needed a video card replaced or something. And I turn around, I look over my shoulder, and I see George Harrison sitting on the sofa. Oh, that's weird, the kids are messing with a dead body.
Oh, what happened?
And my friend was in the kitchen, still. But I could see him, you know, from where I was. He was near the the little opening that goes to the kitchen where you stand there. And I look at him, I say, "There's a beetle in your living room." You know, something like that. I was trying to say it the way the people from Liverpool would say, "There's a beetle in your living room." But I probably laughed just like that. I probably laughed before I finished saying it. Because I'm not really good at keeping a straight face.
Hello, friend.
And George says,
"Oh, thank
you. So you're the computer guy?"
Minds bless you.
I said, "Yep."
"Always good talking to you, friend."
Because my coworker, I didn't know this at the time, but my coworker then says to me that he was a singer back in the day. This group, I forget the guy's name, the famous Indian guy, singer thing. George Harrison hung out with them doing the sitar. Anyway, so my coworker friend, he was one of the singers in the band. So that's how he knew George. Anyway, so George was sitting there watching a World Cup game, I think. It was soccer. I don't know if it was during World Cup or if it was just soccer. And this was back when people had satellite TVs so they can watch everything.
Yes, what is it?
You know, back when satellite TVs got all the stuff. That's why you had a dish in your yard, so you can get all the channels for free. I don't know if it was for free, but whatever was on the satellite, you got to see. Nowadays, I'm sure you have to pay for it all. And you don't get to see all of it. Why is she flipping up like that? I don't get it. Well, Vilya rarely does her weird back-bending exercise when she's armed. Even when she's been riding her horse, so I don't know what was causing her to bend backwards like that. When she would she would arm herself and her back would either be bent forward or backward. Anyway, I forgot what I was going to say about that. When she does do those kinds of weird exercises, what I do is I just go indoors. I go indoors or outdoors, and that fixes her. Or I do a fast travel. I think I do a fast travel somewhere like borrow one of these stagecoach drivers.
Oh, there once was a hero named Ragnar the Red who came riding to right from old Rorik's dead.
I think there was a dragon I was supposed to kill around here. or tell somebody that I killed a dragon? No, I'm supposed to tell somebody that I killed a dragon, right? Let's see if I can get some guards to follow me. I don't know if there's any guards out here because I haven't been to Markarth in ages. They're all indoors still, spawning away so that they can come to their posts. Yeah, there's no guards out here. That is so weird. Why does Skyrim act like that?